Hey everybody, it's Dr. Daria here. Wanted to hop on really quickly and say something and really ask you, what is an autoimmune diet? Why does it matter? And why am I having to go back on it? I wanted to get on today and just kind of get candid with everybody because, as many of you know, I have psoriatic arthritis. I was diagnosed with psoriatic arthritis when I was in residency, and it truly brought me to my knees. I couldn't walk for a while and ended up going on medications and then changed my lifestyle and really got a handle on my arthritis, came off my medications. I've been doing great for 7 or 8 years. And then in the last couple weeks, I wanted to share with you guys, because I wanted to tell you, my arthritis has started to kind of flare. So you can see, you may or not be able to see, this finger is really swollen, holding a pen, hurts. Last night I was reading Harry Potter to my daughter, and just the process of holding the book on my hand hurt. So many of you have asked me about, what is an autoimmune diet? How did I get my arthritis under control? And I did, and it's still so much better than it ever was when, 8 years ago when I had to be on medication. But the reality is, our health is an ongoing thing. And so I want anybody who's watching, if you are struggling with chronic pain or autoimmune arthritis, and hi, David Kirsch, how are you? Or any sort of arthritis or anything autoimmune, put in the comment section. Let me know what you're struggling with, because I am there with you, especially right now. And I want to get my arthritis back under control. I did it once before, and it just means I got to get back on the wagon. So here's the diet I'm going to be going through over the next couple of weeks, really cleaning up my lifestyle again to where I had been in the past, to really get my symptoms under control. If you want to join me, you can hop on over to Facebook under my Dr. Daria page. Those of you who are watching on Facebook, I have my Dr. Daria Health Hacks group. So I'm gonna actually start posting in there if anybody wants to come join in and ask about some arthritis and autoimmune and health and kind of chronic, just really optimizing your symptoms. So I see we have Yummy Lunchy, hi, and Gail, and 07 Petit, are joining. So thank you for everybody who's joining. Put in the comment section. I really want to know, what do y'all want to know about? Here's really high level what I'm going to be doing for my arthritis diet that I started last night. I have cut out what I did several years ago, cutting out really all processed foods, which makes me so sad because, you guys, I love Cheez-Its. I love Cheez-Its, I will admit, but I can't have them. Like right now, my arthritis and my pain in my hands and my knees and my feet, it's bad, and I want to get it under control. And I know that my arthritis is really the canary in the coal mine. So in that way, I'm kind of grateful for it, because it keeps me from falling off the wagon health-wise. It gives me my why. So processed foods, dairy products, and sugar, really, really, really bad culprits that we know for really creating inflammation. David, you're asking what you avoid. So exactly that, processed foods, dairy, and sugar, really important. Some people say they cut out eggs when they talk about inflammation. I think the science is a little mixed on that. It's probably not gonna be one of the first things I cut out. It definitely would not be the first thing. And then gluten. I mean, most gluten is gonna, a lot of those are going to be coming in the source of cutting out my processed foods. I'm going to be cutting out a lot of gluten sources, but I'm also not going to be downing a whole bunch of bread right now for the next couple of weeks. And I'm really trying to eat clean. And this is really for inflammation. So no processed foods, no dairy, no sugar, and cutting back on gluten and eggs. And yes, David Kirsch, it does sound like the New York Body Plan Diet. You guys, David Kirsch is over on Facebook and he's messaging me. He and I just did this amazing webinar. I just have to mention, it's at davidanddaria.com, David, D-A-V-I-D-A-N-D, Daria, D-A-R-R-I-A.com. Go check it out. We really talked about a lot of the really the core of what I'm talking about, are how to break through your obstacles, how to eat well when you don't have a chef or somebody helping you eat well, and how to, you know, really kind of break through those things that have kept you, held you back in the past. So check out that webinar really quickly. David Kirsch, I miss you too. David and I'll do another Facebook Live soon. And I need to get my hands better so I can do his plank workout again, because right now with my hands being swollen, I can't do the plank workout. I don't like being in pain. I don't like it. I want to get back. So y'all know what I'm cutting out. So the other things, what am I eating? A ton of vegetables. So a lot of leafy greens, a lot of those sulfuric vegetables and mushrooms and asparagus and cauliflower, and then color. I got a whole Ziploc bag today of some blackberries I'm gonna be chowing down on in the middle of my shift. Really important. And then what are we talking about? So we've had your produce. Remember, I talk about the trifecta on your plate. I don't care if you're losing weight or eating to help your arthritis, I don't want you counting calories or carbs or protein. Like, I don't even care about that remotely. Look at your plate. I want 60% of it to be produce, 30% of it to be good protein, and 10% to be good fat. If you do that, it doesn't matter. You don't have to count anything. So there's my produce. That's 60% is produce. Then you want to have good protein. So what is that? That is fatty fish. That's with those omega-3s you can get from salmon. I want your protein to also be, if you eat red meat when you're having that, I want it to be really grass-fed. That makes a big difference in having more omega-3s in the grass-fed. Of course, you want to minimize anything being treated with antibiotics or hormones, anything like that. And then once you've got those two things, then go to for some fermented foods. Those fermented foods are going to help with your microbiome and really help with your health. Seaweed is a great source of minerals and vitamins, so try to have that. Nuts and seeds, moving up in my little pyramid, nuts and seeds. And then, of course, remember I said 10% healthy fats. So extra virgin olive oil, especially the cold pressed extra virgin olive oil, is going to be really important. And then other ones that you can have. And you know what David said? How about beans and legumes? I do have beans and legumes. I think it's important. Some people may say that it can trigger. You hear all sorts of crazy autoimmune diets about these different things. I think beans and legumes are an important source of, it's when you're talking about an autoimmune diet that's sustainable, an important source of both fiber and protein, lots of vitamins and minerals. So yes, I do eat beans and legumes. They fall under, I kind of think of them in produce, but produce really classically sense is your leafy greens and also those vegetables. But I think beans and legumes are important. So I'm trying not to be super strict. And then, oh, back to healthy fats, because David Kirsch, he's like my prompter. Who needs his teleprompter when you have David Kirsch? Love you, David Kirsch. Check him out. He's at David Kirsch. Gotta give him a shout out. So he asked about coconut oil. So really, I'm the biggest fan of when it comes to fats, of going for things that are unsaturated. So that's your olive oil, that's gonna be your avocado oil, that's gonna be a little bit of your sesame oil, things like that. Coconut oil is a lot of saturated fat. The one thing I like about coconut oil is that coconut oil does have a high smoke point. So if you're cooking something that's getting super, super, super hot, coconut oil may be a good thing to put in there because it's not going to oxidize your food as much. But otherwise, we know extra virgin olive oil is really good for you, especially the cold press type. So I tend to stick to that. Unless you're really cooking something that you think is going to mess up with the flavor, then, or going to be too hot again, then you can go for coconut oil. So that's going to be my diet. I'm even, you guys know I love my Diet Cokes. I used to drink them all the time, but I really cut back a lot in the last several months. Dr. Oz and Dr. Mike Roizen always gave me a really hard time about my Diet Coke, so I cut back on them. I really felt they were making a big difference, impact on my health, on my microbiome, and even on my skin. But every once in a while, I'd still have a sip or two. But with my autoimmune diet, it's kind of goodbye Diet Cokes, which is sad, but it's okay. Coffee, green tea, and really saying goodbye to any artificial sweeteners as well, because you guys, I'm gonna get this arthritis back under control. I did it once before. I'm gonna do it again, and I want you to do it with me. Anybody who's suffering with chronic pain or any autoimmune condition or anything like that, we can do this together. So put in the comment section if you do want me to really relive that Dr. Daria Health Hacks Facebook group. I can do this. We can do this together, but I want to know that you want me to do it first. So put in the comment section if you do want me to do it, and we'll do it together. I want to share with you, and I'll keep you posted as I'm doing this because last night I so wanted a little bit of candy that my daughter was having, and I didn't because my why is not to have pain. My why is so that when my children have children, I can walk and I can run and I can play with them, and my arthritis will not define me. Defeating it and controlling it is what will. And it's the same thing for you. Whatever you are struggling with, that condition will not define you. You overcoming it is what can define you. Put in your comment section what you're struggling with. Please let me know. I want to help you with it. I want to be there with you side by side. Put in the comment section what you're struggling with. And if you want to join me in that Dr. Daria Health Hacks Facebook group, if you do, I will get it going and we'll relive it and I'll start to post in there again. But let me know first before I do. And you guys, we'll do this together. You've got this. I have got this. You have got this, okay? Instagram, you've got this. Facebook, you've got this. I will see you guys on the other side. I will post more later today and tomorrow, and we're in this together. Bye, guys. Have a really good day.